Hello.
Hello. My paper on the fractionated dipole antenna has been selected as one of the highlights of the March issue of MRM. I was therefore invited to provide these audio slides to present my paper in a nutshell. I will start off by showing some previous results to explain a little why we started using dipole antennas in the first place.
For an antenna, two regions are distinguished. There is the near field close to the antenna, where the field density is very high due to the resonant currents and voltages in the antenna itself. While in the far field, the field is a propagating wave consisting of both electric and magnetic field that is traveling away from the antenna. Now, and this graph also shows that for higher field strengths or higher frequencies, the wavelength gets smaller, but also the near field gets smaller, which is also beautifully depicted by the two movies on the right, where you can see a region of interest at 10 centimeter depth for a loop coil emitting B1 field into a tissue-like phantom. And you can see that at 1.5D, the region of interest is very much in the near field, whereas at 7 Tesla, the region of interest is very much in a wave-like regime, which is approaching the far field. So this shows that for posted imaging at 7 Tesla, we need a different type of coil, or actually, we need an antenna. An antenna should generate both magnetic and electric fields, and the pointing vector should be oriented towards the imaging target. The near field should be kept as small as possible or kept outside of the imaging subject. With these ideas, we have developed an antenna that has been known as the single-sided adapted dipole antenna and was published in 2012. And we were able to get fairly good image qualities with this. However, the use of a ceramic spacer, as indicated in the photo, has a disadvantage that is very heavy and is difficult to work with.
Now, for this paper, we have investigated the use of a simple plain dipole antenna. We used numerical simulations where we placed a dipole antenna with various lengths at 2 centimeter distance from a tissue-like phantom. If you now look at the B1 plus profile along the green dashed lines as indicated in the images, you can notice in the diagrams below that for short antennas, the field intensity at the surface is very high, while for longer antennas, it's lower. But if we take everything relative to the single-sided adapted dipole antenna, which is plotted in black, you can see in the second diagram that actually a lot of antennas are performing better than the single-sided adapted dipole antenna. In addition, we can notice that for larger depth, longer antennas are favorable, whereas for shallow depth, it's better to use small antennas.
Now, if you look at the size distribution, you can see the same thing happening. For short antennas, the SAR levels at the surface are the highest, while for longer antennas, the SAR levels are much lower. Now, if you take a look at the ratio of B1 plus over the maximum SAR, which is indicated in the second diagram relative to the single-sided adapted dipole antenna, we can see that now for a depth of 10 centimeters, that's actually much longer antennas of 30 centimeters or even longer that have the best performance. Now, an additional finding that comes out from this study is these SAR peaks that you can see for very short antennas. They are associated to the conservative electric fields that you can see at the endings of a dipole. And these were the reasons that people were reluctant to use SAR dipole antennas for MR imaging in the first place. However, we see that these SAR peaks actually disappear for longer antennas. And this is probably because the induced electric fields in the center become more dominant. Now, how can we improve on this? The idea came to be to take a dipole antenna and split the legs of the antenna into segments and then interconnect these segments with lumped elements that could be inductors or capacitors. In a simulation environment, it would look like this. Now, if you take a look at the field distributions of such an antenna, we can see that the capacitor in between the segments actually shortens the effective length of the dipole, whereas adding inductors between the segments actually lengthens the effective length of the dipole. And then if we look at the profiles along the green dashed lines, we can see that the capacitors enhance the B1 plus field, where inductors actually reduce the B1 plus field. And the second diagram, where everything is plotted relative to the plane dipole, shows that this effect is actually most pronounced at the surface and decays at larger depths. Look at SAR distribution. We can also see that capacitors enhance the SAR levels while inductors reduce the SAR levels. And then, of course, it becomes interesting to look at the ratio of B1 plus over the maximum SAR. And there we can see that for a depth of 10 centimeters, it's actually inductors, large inductors of 100 nanohenry, that perform the best of all the investigated cases. Now, from these findings, we have developed the fractionated dipole antenna, which is an antenna where the legs are divided into segments and the segments are interconnected with the meander that serves as an inductor. And we have created an array of 8 elements for prostate imaging, where the elements are aligned around the pelvis as indicated in the image. So we simulated the performance of such a design in comparison to our old design, the single-sided dipole antenna, and it demonstrates a tremendous improvement of the SAR level. Whereas if you look at the similar to B1 plus value, it stays more or less the same. So here this slide demonstrates the imaging results that we have obtained on the volunteer using 8 × 2 kW RF power. We were able to achieve 17 microtesla and a very good image quality. So now we investigated the robustness of the array towards various imaging subjects with widely varying BMI values. And you can see from these scatter parameter plots that both reflection and coupling are very acceptable for this wide range of investigated volunteers. If you look at the image quality, it's not that superior because the fat suppression pulse didn't work correctly. But if you look at the B1 plus values, you can see that we were able to reach 12 microtesla for a subject with a BMI of 27.5, up to 18 microtesla for subjects with a BMI of only 20. Now, this antenna is now being used routinely at our institute for a wide range of applications. Here I'll show 2 more of them. Now, this slide shows kidney imaging at 7 tesla, where we can see a very good image quality for T2 weighted images. And also, the T1 weighted images that were acquired have a very good quality, as is shown by this slide. Now, these results have been recently been accepted for publication in a paper in Magma 2016. Now, we've also been performing cardiac imaging at 7 tesla with these antennas. However, to adapt to the curvature of the chest, we had to develop bent dipoles to make it all happen. And still, you can see that the image quality is very good. In addition, we have been performing coronary artery imaging, where the human heart has 3 coronary arteries, and we were able to depict all 3 of them within the reasonable imaging times and a very good image quality. Now, in conclusion, using dipole antennas for ultra-high field MR imaging, ceramic spacers are not needed to avoid peak SAR levels at the endings of the dipole. Peak SAR levels at the endings only occur for short dipoles. An antenna length of 30 cm is optimal for the ratio of maximum SAR over B1 plus level at depth. And the fractionated dipole antenna design allows the manipulation of the dipole antenna behavior. For example, the SAR level can be improved by another 20% when using appropriate inter-element inductors. The resulting fractionated dipole antenna design provides good quality images for a wide range of imaging applications. And the easy setup with fixed tuning and matching still provides a good quality result for a wide variety of subject anatomies. With that, I would like to thank you for your attention and time. Goodbye.